Hi guys, this is Shweta here and welcome back to my channel. So I'm really excited about today's video because it's going to be a huge makeup haul from Faces Canada. I'm going to use the makeup for the very first time on camera in front of you guys and telling you guys what I like about it and what I don't. So let's begin. So we're going to be first starting with the primer here, which is this one. It's also for pore minimizing, which is required because I have huge pores on my nose area. So it looks okay. A good primer will make sure that your makeup stays for a longer period of time and gives a very nice smooth base to work on. This one is pretty smooth actually. And the texture is very lightweight. So really like this primer. So the next thing we're going to use is of course a foundation. So this is the Prime Perfect foundation. The shade I got is this one. It looks very similar to the shade that I am. So I'm going to quickly use a sponge. It's a low to medium coverage foundation and I actually like the texture. It's very soft, it's not very liquidy. It's not at all flaky or dry for my skin, and honestly I have a very dry skin, so a bad patchy foundation is a big no-no because it just makes my skin look flaky as F. So I have used a good amount. And it is a yellow undertone color. I can see that very clearly. And because my skin tone is yellow undertone as well, so it matched up pretty well. I really like the foundation. So the next thing we're going to try out is the concealer. Now, I think a lot of people use the concealer first and then use the foundation. I try to do the opposite. I'm more comfortable with that since it makes the concealer look more like highlighted on my face. So here is the wand. Okay, so let's try it out. But it does feel a little oily. You can see the sheen a little bit. Yeah, so it's like that. And it did feel a little liquidy as well, but fine. I mean, this is not perhaps the best, but I think this is fine. It's good. I like the shade. So the next thing that we'll be using is a shadow palette. This is their ever popular Ultimate Pro eyeshadow palette. We're going to quickly do a look on our eyes using this palette and seeing how it works on us. I already see some color. It is not visible on the camera, but it is visible here. If you want maximum pigment out of your eyeshadow, the best way is to use your fingers. It does definitely have some fallout and it's a little more powdery than I thought, but the pigment is nice. The texture of the eyeshadows are very soft. Next shade we're going to be trying out is a more darker shade, so I'm going to be trying out this purple here. I know a lot of you ladies outside are very scared of dark shades, especially when you're using darker eyeshadows because you tend to mess it up very easily. I would suggest just to use a triangle form when you are applying. A triangle form will actually give you a better application and it won't smudge that color very much with the inner shade. So always try to form a triangle on the corner. I'm going to use a metallic shade from the color range. Use this one. Oh, wow. When you use the finger, it comes off almost like a liquid eyeshadow. Oh my God, this is so pigmented. Okay, so we used it. We're just going to use a pat brush and we're going to like merge it up so it doesn't look messy. I really like it. It's a little messy, of course. It looks a little dark tone. I think this look is great for night look. So if you're going out on like in a club or so, this will actually look really pretty. The colors are very pretty and like they look very soft, but they can actually work as a great color for occasion wear as well if you try to use it in the right way. So this was the eyeshadow palette. So the next thing we're going to be using is an eyeliner, and I got their Ultimo Pro eyeliner as well. It's a little different, but I don't think I can do much corrections right now, so I'm okay with it. I think it looks fine. I really enjoy using matte eyeliners, and this one dried out really fast and gave a very nice defined look. The applicator that it had is a little stiff, so it's easier to draw lines with. It doesn't like go and, you know, make it flexible and do all that. I really, really love this eyeliner. We're gonna do some corrections here where the eyeshadow is spreading across. Corrections with a nice normal earbud and some makeup remover. So it's a very easy way of getting rid of any excess eyeshadow. Little bit of the foundation and you are good to go. So the next thing we're going to be trying out is of course our favorite, some mascara, and I got the Ultimo Pro one as well. So this particular mascara is with argan oil. Now this one has a pretty broad applicator. Okay, I really love this mascara. Doesn't seem like it clumps at all. I really like the applicator. Really easy to use, and you can see an immediate result in front of you guys. I do not use fake lashes. I always prefer natural mascara and lashes, so yeah. I'm going to use a little bit of the mascara on my eyebrow because we do not have an eyebrow pencil here. I just go very light. I do not put any excess mascara. Just put in with light hands. Just go ahead and pull it and brush it up, and it just goes really well. So you can see it immediately filled up my gap without too much effort. Using the mascara for your eyebrows is a very shortcut method. I won't recommend it if you are using a normal eyebrow pencil. So the next thing we're going to be using is an illuminator, and illuminators are supposed to be used with the foundation. You can add it to a foundation and it can like, it adds a kind of glow and shine, and like it has shiny particles which kind of glow. So if you're like going at night and you want your face to look really shiny, this is a way to do it. Since we've already put the foundation and I don't want to really do that glowy look, I'm going to be using this illuminator as a highlighter. Oh, this, wow, this looks so pretty, right? We're just going to apply it on our higher points. I'm going to use the sponge very, very fast because I think it's drying up very quickly. Okay, I don't think a sponge is going to work because it's drying up very quickly. Use your fingers, I think that's the best way. It gives a really nice natural glow. I wish it was like not drying so fast. My only complaint, it's very dry very quickly, or else the shade is very pretty, as you guys can see. And for the lips, I'm really excited about this one. This is their premium lipstick, and also comes in a very beautiful dust bag. It's so pretty. Like, I've never really seen a premium lipstick like this from any other range. So once you open it up, this is how the beautiful lipstick comes out. It looks like a jewel cut design with like golden, really nice glossy pack. It has a magnet pack, so it kind of goes magnet. Super, super pigmented. It has one of the lightest textures I've ever used for a lipstick. I really highly recommend you guys try this out in case you get your hands on this one. You're not going to regret it. With that, we are done with our look. But I do have a few more products that I got my hands on. I'm just going to show you guys one nail so you know exactly the kind of shade it is. It's like a rustic orange. Really pretty, right? And the last thing that I got is very interesting. Has a nice sponge in it, and they have the remover in it. So I'm going to quickly show you guys how I remove it. This is the nail paint, and it's gone. See, it's just like instant. It removes your nail paint so quick, and you don't really have to do anything. It's so easy. So really, really love this. So guys, my look is done. Let's check out my final look. So guys, with that, we are done with today's look. Hope you really enjoyed this video and I could help you guys. It's not a sponsored video, so all these products have been bought by me and I tried it out in front of you guys for the first time, and I was really surprised with some of the things which turned out to be really pretty good, and some were okay and average, but overall, if I have to talk about the brand, it is one of the best brands I've used, especially drugstore wise. A few of the products are a little more expensive, but you're getting the quality against that, so this is definitely a brand that you should try out. They do have a lot of different ranges. You also have ranges which are more affordable and pocket friendly, whereas you also have some ranges which are more expensive and premium, so they have everything under one roof. Go ahead and check out Faces Canada's entire range. I'll be linking down the ranges that I can get online in the description box for you guys. It is available on Nykaa, on Flipkart, Amazon and Too Good and other places as well, so you can go ahead and check that out. And with that, we're done with today's video. Be safe, be positive and be beautiful. Ciao!